Welcome to another vintage event here on Channel Fireball. I'm picking up a deck I don't normally play. In fact, normally I always lose to this deck. I always lose to workshop decks, you know, Mishra's workshops decks, which is just all artifacts. And this time I want to be on the side of the Mishra's workshop deck. I assume I'm still going to lose, but, you know, because workshop's involved. But hey, so I'm playing a deck I like to call Frobots. It's actually a deck that was played in one of the bigger tournaments in Spain, but Eric Froehlich used it upon my urging to win the finals of the Vintage Super League. It's similar to, you know, a normal workshop deck, which is it powers out Sphere of Resistance, Lodestone Golem, Chalice of the Void, but its kill package is Arcbound Ravager, Triskelion, Porcelain Legionnaire, and Sword of Fire Ice. So I made a couple adjustments, but the main premise of this deck is just to make it so your opponent can't cast spells between the various Sphere effects, you know, including the big one, Trinisphere, Tangle Wire, and then Chalice, as well as Lodestone Golem, plus Revoker, which can turn off Moxes, Black Lotus Soaring, or Planeswalkers, and then kill them with, you know, something like Lodestone Golem, which is why Lodestone Golem is just incredible, but also with the other threats. And part of the reason between the other threats is that Trike Ravager is a nice little combo. You can use it to kill annoying young Pyromancer or Delvers. Sword of Fire Nice lets you bash past things and, again, kill cards like Delver or Young Pyromancer. And then Metamorph and Batterskull are more for the mirror than anything else. The sideboard has four Graft Digger's Cages and a Tabernacle. The Graft Digger's Cages against Oath and Dredge, Tabernacle against decks that make a lot of creatures. And then a bunch of cards against the mirror, like Worm Coils, Crucibles, Ghost Quarters, partially because this deck's so pre-boarded against the blue decks. So let's see how this deck does. All right, round one of a daily event. My opponent kept seven. I am going to keep this hand. It's not fantastic, but it does get to go turn one Revoker, turn two Revoker Wasteland, which puts a decent amount of pressure on the opponent's mana. So I get to revoke that Mox. And if my opponent has turn one Pyromancer, well, I guess they don't. Dark Confidant, huh? All right. Well, yeah, Porcelain Legionnaire, you're a card. All right. Pretty easy Frex and... Oh, wait, no. That's literally a Mox Jet. All right. Well, in that case, let's play this. If it was not literally Mox Jet, I would be a lot more excited about revoking it, but I don't really want to revoke my own Mox. I might next turn put Revealed Abrupt Decay. But... And I can name Mox Emerald, and that will be fine. Mishra's Workshop is still really the card I'm looking to draw here. Abrupt Decaying Legionnaire, Wastelanding, Mishra's Factory. Alright. I don't love this position, I'm not gonna lie. Come on, Workshop. Huh, that's a Workshop. Alright. Let's play Phyrexian Revoker. Naming Deathrite Shaman. Didn't even see the Deathrite come out, but there it is. Alright, and another Phyrexian Revoker naming Mox Emerald. Actually, yeah, no, I gotta name Mox. I could have named Mox Jet to cut my opponent off of black, but I feel like, given that I want to cast Triskelion here, it would be unwise to do that. Alright, my opponent revealed a Snapcaster Mage, especially since any one land, and the only reason to name Jet or Emerald is it cuts off black, but almost any land produces black for my opponent. So, barring like literally drawing a Tropical Island. Oof, Wasteland, I do not want to see that. Because I'm actually somewhat short on mana myself here, especially given that I want to cast something like Triskelion. Right, another Abrupt Decay, clearly killing the one naming Deathrite. Opponent's hand is now a Snapcaster Mage. I assume I'm getting Wastelanded here. Alright, I'm the one who can't cast spells somehow. Sphere Resistance, not really what I'm looking for here. I'm just going to play Arcbound Ravager. And I think actually attack. I suspect my opponent will not block. Now, one of my win conditions here is my opponent revealing a bunch of Force of Wills. No, more Abrupt Decays. My opponent's Abrupt Decay flooded. And normally Abrupt Decay is just an okay card against workshops because it is kind of hard to cast, but my opponent being on the play and having turn one Dark Confidant and three Wastelands in a row means that I'm actually the one who can't cast spells. My opponent can do everything. Alright, that's fine. I could have sacked the Mox to make the Revoker bigger. I think I want to just hope to draw, like, running workshops or workshop plus Tolarian Academy or something like that. As unlikely as that sounds, opponent's hand is now Snapcaster Mage, and they can just gain life off Death Rite. I guess they can't gain life this turn. Alright. Well, I'm the one locked out. So let's go on the offensive here. Again, if my opponent goes to 8, then reveals four soul and goes to 3, they could just die the turn after that. Okay, my opponent exiles a land. You still can't cast Snapcaster Mage, though, because that Mox Emerald still doesn't tap for mana. So, it's not going to do what you want it to do. Alright, opponent goes to 8. Untap, reveal, Verdant Catacombs. I mean, I feel like I can't quite concede, even though my opponent does get to go, like, Snapcaster, Abrupt Decay, Revoker, and then gain life off Deathrite until they don't die. But technically, they could reveal a bunch of forces, and also technically, they could just draw a workshop and cast Lodestone Golem, which opponent may actually not be able to deal with. All right, so I assume this is Snapcaster. This could be Snapcaster Decay or Mox, actually, which it's funny that I'm the one being unable to cast spells, though that may not be how you want to tap your mana. You can't actually cast Abrupt Decay now. I mean, I'm going to lose, but I do get the moral victory of my opponent just let's just say making a bunch of plays that they probably somewhat regret. Yeah, Abrupt Decay doesn't get to get cast now because, again, Mox Emerald still can't tap for mana. If I peel Workshop, could be a thing. Well, I didn't. I'm not going to Wasteland here. My opponent's got lots of mana. I do not. So I'm just going to pass. Force of Will? Yep, there's a Force of Will. Bam. Opponent's on now on 3, so I, again, technically have a shot. My opponent now gets to attack. I'm going to take it. I want Bob in play here, even though I'm not able to cast spells. All right, opponent can gain 2. I guess they have to, like, gain 2 end of turn. But actually, all right. I think they have a Verdant Catacombs. Actually, I think I do Wasteland the Trop now, because my opponent doesn't have another green source. They have Verdant Catacomb in hand, but that cost them a life. It could add up. And now they can't gain life on upkeep, which means if they reveal another Force of Will, I do win the game. Oh, they revealed Vendilion Click, down to 2. Go to 1 to use Verdant Catacombs. Oh no, they drew Bayou, so we're down to basically just Force of Will at this point. And opponent does get to cast Vendilion Click, but then there's actually 2 more creatures in the graveyard right now. I guess I block Snapcaster here. Yeah, because then I go to 8, then I get maybe two more turns. Though my opponent can also use Deathrite's other ability. The opponent doesn't have double blue without using Deathrite, so if they want to cast Vendilion Click, they do have to tap that Deathrite Shaman. This puts more creatures in the graveyard, but I don't think I'm lasting long enough for the Deathrite to run out of fuel. I just have to hope that the life loss outpaces that somehow. So I need to draw his Workshop to play Lodestone. Oh geez, how did I let myself play this Ravager? All right, so one gains life, goes up to 4, then gains life and goes up to 6. Well, it's going to be tough. I have to just hope to hit, again, more Force of Wills than is possible. They hit another Force of Will. All right. But I'm going to take 2 down to 6. Opponent maybe can't cast Vendilion Click this turn. And then has to hit a 3-drop or greater for me to win the game. Is what it looks like here. I feel like I really deserve it here. Come on, sack Verdant Catacombs just once. I would allow it. All right. No, let's not play Chalice for 0 because I actually might want to draw Lotus more than my opponent. All right, so my opponent's going to use Deathrite. Hopefully they hit another Vendilion. It has to be Vendilion, Force of Will, Trigon, Predator, or Jace are the commonly listed cards. Come on. Bam. Yep, they're dead. They hit Trigon, Predator. All right, well, that was another luck skill victory. Though, honestly, if my opponent had just cast Abrupt Decay off Snapcaster, I would have just been dead. So that's actually my opponent's fault, not mine. What do I want? I definitely want Dismember because it kills Trigon Predator. I like Sword of Fire and Ice, I think. It does get Abrupt Decayed, but it's just a very strong card. Chalice of the Void seems okay on the play. Or I'm on the draw now because I somehow won that game. I don't love Chalice as much on the draw. Because I do like cards like Wurmcoil against like the fairer decks, Wurmcoil and Batterskull. And maybe even Duplicate. It's a lot of expensive cards, but maybe I bring in Ghost Guard. Actually, I could bring in... Well, probably bring in Crucibles. My opponent has Deathrite Shaman, so I don't really love that. Metamorph can also block Trigons. Let Trigons be Trigons. Let's take out Trinisphere. I think I take out some of the Disruption spells. So I clicked on the first Ravager when I'm building my deck, so I saw, okay, it's Darksteel Ravager, Darksteel Ravager, and boom, Modern Master Ravager, though I have plenty of the other one. Anyway, I think I want to take out some amount of the Disruptive cards here, just because I just have all these big expensive cards, and my opponent doesn't have a ton of cheap spells. I think Chalice is okay. Though, just looking at these, you know, three color, these are kind of like bug decks. They have cards like Abrupt Decay, and then they have, I guess, and Trigon Predator is one of their main plans. So I like having answers to that. Sword is also, I guess, kind of an answer to Trigon Predator. I don't love Thorns as much because, I mean, I think Tangowar is okay, but Thorn does, like, all those fears don't seem as good. Though Tabernacle actually could be kind of sweet. My opponent's on a lot of creatures. I kind of have a lot of creatures too. Maybe Tabernacle, and then I guess I can just Chalice for one a lot of the time. Alright. Let's see how that goes. Or my opponent can play Dark Confidant and take something like 16 damage off Dark Confidant. That works too. Alright. I'm going to keep this. It's not a great hand, but it's got double Mishra's Factory in my opponent's mulliganing. It's got Tangowire, which isn't great, but it's also got a lot of lands, and my opponent's on a Wasteland deck. And I can actually attack my opponent with Mishra's Factories. All right. Deathrite Shaman. Let's cast Tangowire. Might as well make it so my opponent can't cast Trigon Predator quite yet. This is the kind of hand that wants to draw one of those expensive cards that I sided in. You know, the Batterskulls and duplicate type cards. Phyrexian Revoker wouldn't be awful either. I guess I wouldn't even hate something like a Wasteland, though. Actually, no, I wouldn't. I would prefer not to. Alright, let's make sure we fade first, then tap three permanents. Spells. I just want spells. That's a spell. That is a spell. Alright. Lodestone Golem. If my opponent doesn't have Force of Will, they're in for a bit of pain here. Can't Nature's Claim. My opponent may have Nature's Claim in hand now. Nature's Claim, another reason to Chalice for one. It looks like Tangowire is just happening. Opponent's still on no black mana, and there's the black mana. But not a whole lot to Abrupt Decay. Abrupt Decay is not at its best against a deck that routinely plays cards that cost way more mana. All right, let's fade, and then tap down two things. I don't love Ancient Tomb, but it's Animate Factory, play a factory, and one trick. I normally use F8 a lot. You cannot F8 when you have Mishra's Workshops in your deck, because you'll tap the mana, then it'll just pass the turn, so don't do that. Snuff Out. Okay. I mean, that's a fine card. And I guess I'll play Tangowire. Oh, did I F8? I did the thing I said I shouldn't do. Alright, well, I should have another Tangowire in play. It's not even like Tangowire is insane here or anything, but that is ridiculous. Did I really F8? I thought I specifically didn't F8 because of that. I guess not. Alright, well, there we are. I do like that was a bug 6 months ago or more when I made the last video with Mishra's Workshops in my deck, but hey. What can you do? Apparently not fix it, but really, what can you do? Alright, opponent's still on just 2 mana. Deathrite Shaman Remembered doesn't tap for mana right now. These death rates aren't good. And I just want to draw big artifacts. I'm glad I took all those stupid spheres out of my deck. I just want giant things. And that's why Chalice is good, because Chalice is good early and actually not a horrible draw late. Alright, I like Lodestone Golem. Let's play that. And I could attack with 2 Mishra's Factories, but I think I'd rather just attack with 1 and pump it. The reason being that I would not want my opponent to double block and trade a Deathrite for a Mishra's Factory. That seems bad for me. I could also, if my opponent doesn't block, actually just cast Tango Arrow, so I'm probably going to do that. I assume my opponent's not blocking here. Tango Arrow losing effectiveness here as my opponent plays more death rites and whatnot, but that is okay. The worst death rites ever. My opponent can gain 2 life here, but cannot do anything else with those death rites. Then on upkeep, has to tap 5 permanents down, go down to like 1 land essentially, and then next turn I get to attack for 9. And I have enough mana that if I draw anything awesome, then I get to do awesome things with it. Alright, Lodestone Golem gets eaten. As expected. Tangoyer comes out. Entangles my opponent in approximately 5 counters worth of wire. If my opponent has a more expensive spell, they can also cast it on upkeep and then just tap everything down. Instants are decent against Tangle Wire, but it looks like that is not happening. At least the first Tangle Wire has resolved. I guess my opponent may be considering using the other death rite to remove Snuff Out and drain me for 2. That doesn't seem super relevant right now, given that I'm at 18, so maybe keeping your mana up or keeping a death rite on tap, perhaps, is better. Though you can't really cast a whole lot with Lodestone Golem in play here. Alright, well, Tango is resolving, leaving 1 death rite in play. And a Bayou. Still can't really cast anything unless it costs 0. Alright, let's put these on the stack. The other thing you want to do is this Tango Wire is fading down to 0, so next turn I want to stack it so I can tap it to my other Tango Wire before it goes away. And I guess I could tap these. I could have tapped Ancient Tomb, but it would have ended up not taking damage, but I don't care too much about that. I assume this is not the one I played this turn. And it looks like it's not. Alright, cool. So now I get to attack my opponent for 10, down to 3, and then they're probably dead to Mishra's Factories. I have to have something pretty nice to get out of this, because remember, we're still tapping 3 permanents on upkeep. Though a card like Hercule's Recall is something I need to watch out for. Because if my opponent has Hercule's Recall, it could be disastrous if I just like animate all my Mishra's Factories and just charge everything in there. Though currently my opponent can't cast Hercule's Recall. They have 2 mana. The death rites do not provide mana. Alright, they get to cast Ancestral and then Wasteland, and they're not just dead, but they have to like chump Lodestone Golem, Wasteland Mishra's Factory, chump Mishra's Factory, I guess. Alright, so I guess let's see. This one's fading, so I want to put this one on the... No. I want to put... that one. Alright, that one doesn't matter, so I can just put that on the stack. And then I want to put this fading on the stack, and then I want to put this on the stack. I think that was right. Alright, so this fades down to 2. Now I have to tap 2 permanents. Alright, and then this one goes away, and then that one goes away. Alright. Opponent can't cast. So I attack with 3 opponent blocks, wastelands, and has to block. Yep. There's no way to not take damage here, I don't think. I mean, I could attack with two, but I think just attacking with three is good because my opponent has to chump block here. So send in the squad. Opponent gets to go, well, gets, opponent has to go death rate. I guess they actually can tap for two mana now because they get to wasteland a Mishra's factory, and then that means the death rates can add two mana to their mana pool. Not a whole lot they can cast with that two mana, but it's there. I guess they can add one mana, then death rate to exile Ancestral to drain me for two down to 10. My life total is not particularly under question, though. And then I suppose I just play another Mishra's Workshop. Alright, and it looks like I'm getting drained off Ancestral. It's not even clear to... Oh. They're getting black-green. Well, you can't cast Abrupt Decay, so you could cast, like, Snuff Out or something, but, yeah. And if they were going to do that, they would have just not blocked Lodestone Golem. Then they go to one. Have to tap two permanents, and there's a Lodestone Golem playing two Mishra's Factories in play, so Hercule's Recall is the card I'd be looking out for here, but apparently opponent doesn't have it. All right, on the board with Mishra's Workshops. Nice.